Hi, kids, and welcome to the Mask Fan Attic once again. You know, way back in the year 1963, there was a spooky little movie that came out. Not particularly well produced or directed or acted or anything like that, but actually it was still somehow pretty creepy and made young people everywhere afraid to walk past manhole covers and sewer grates and things because they feared that the monsters were going to come out like in the movie. And that was 20 years before the Chuds did the same thing in the 80s. That was, in fact, in the 60s. The Slime People! And that was the name of the movie, The Slime People. Now, The Slime People came up out of the ground, as I just mentioned, and, you guys got there 20 years before the Chuds started making people scared to walk past manhole covers. Props for that, Slime People. Yeah. Gimme five. No, wait, now that I think of it, I don't want to do a high five with a slime person because there's that messy splat when you do that, and the slime goes everywhere and you get it all over your hand, and it just, well, anyway, I won't give you the high five, but I'll give you a nod of respect because you guys got there first with regard to the sewers and the manhole covers and all that cool stuff. Anyway, the Slime People from 1963 looked an awful lot like this. In fact, this face is amazingly it's like really accurate and at the same time a little bit better than the real ones in the movie, if that makes any sense. Well, that's the case even if it doesn't make any sense, come to think of it. But this, see this sort of structure around his head, this sort of hood looking. In the movie, that's actually bigger. Like this comes out farther, this comes clear out to his shoulders. He's a little more of a hunchback looking effect going on, more of a humped look to him, to all of them. There's supposed to be a whole race of them. Now, they didn't have many costumes. I think they only had a couple of costumes, but they tried to shoot it from a lot of different angles and make it look like the slime people were all over the place. So, as far as we know, all the slime people have these big hoodie things. Now, the decision was made in 1996 when the time came for somebody to finally make a mask of one of the slime people. The decision was made to scale, no pun intended, this big outer structure down a little bit to make it a little more, user-friendly, collector-friendly, wearer-friendly. Yeah, even slime-friendly. Make it a little smaller, although the face is the same. Now, this fabulous thing, I love this thing. This was sculpted in 1996 at the behest of a collector named Ray Shope, a guy in Indiana, sculpted by the amazing John Smith. And yes, his real name really is John Smith. And no, his middle name is not Jacob Jingleheimer, so let's get that out of the way right now. John Smith, who I think is one of the most talented sculptors ever in the history of masks and has yet to get his due, you know? Not like his glass of Mountain Dew. I drank that when he wasn't looking. To get his the respect he deserves and the recognition he deserves as one of the best sculptors in the history of modern rubber masks, I think. But anyway, this is one of his creations, and as I previously stated, it's very, very close to what you saw in the movie, only a little bit better because it's slightly more natural and organic looking. And as far as reducing the size of this big pointy cone hood shaped thing, I think that was a good idea. For one thing, to have made it full size would have increased the cost tremendously, and who's going to pay a fortune for a slime person mask? Okay, maybe me, but not too many others out there would. So, now only a few of these were made, very few. It was never officially released, just a few were made for people who knew either Ray Shope or John Smith at the time and managed to get their claws on one. Now, I painted this one, although the others I've seen were painted pretty similarly, sometimes a little greener, a little more grass green than this. I went with this kind of murky, brownish, muddy green and brown color scheme, but I'm not basing that on anything. I just made that up. So I don't know if that's accurate. That's just what I imagine a slime person would look like, don't you think? And these things, which do appear in the movie, whatever these are, they're not part of the sculpture. They're separately cast and glued on there, and I just made those by taking a little bit of clay, and you know, you roll clay between the palms of your hands and make a little worm out of it. I just did that and then threw some plaster on it and then made latex castings of these two little things and glued them on so he could have those catfish-looking appendages on the corners of his mouth, because it adds a little character to him, I think. But what a great mask with a great monster face, and maybe not the Citizen Kane of slime movies necessarily, but still fun and spooky in an old-fashioned kind of way. And these guys are creepy and gross. They come out of the fog at night and they're all slimy and disgusting, and they make these horrible belching noises the whole time, and they're scary. And if you're a little kid who saw this on if you were a little kid who saw this on television in the 60s or 70s, they were probably really scary because they came out of the fog at night and out of the manholes and so forth. So he's going to go back down there because he's got a card game lined up tonight with some chuds. So I got to get him back to the sewer, and I'll just leave you up here in the attic. Goodbye.